enable.
With consumers expecting a new level of personalized communication and revenue pressures requiring a more efficient marketing mix, banks and financial sector institutions are turning to MarTech solutions to meet these challenges. Hello and welcome to Netcore and CNBC-TV18 presents MarTech Marathon 12x25, a special series that focuses on the impact of technology in marketing. And today our focus is on the banking sector. And to share their perspective on the changing banking landscape, we have with us Radhika Binani, Chief Product Officer and Senior Director, PaisaBazaar.com, Mrityunjay Mahapatra, Deputy Managing Director, Strategy and Chief Digital Officer, State Bank of India, Praveen Bhatt, Head Digital Banking and Customer Experience, Axis Bank, Rakesh Vadva, Chief Marketing Officer, Future Generali Life Insurance, Veerchand Botra, CIO, Netcore, and Deepak Sharma, Chief Digital Officer, Kotak Mahindra Bank. All of you, welcome to the show. So much is changing around us, and so is the customer need and customer demand. I'll come to you first, Mr. Mrityunjay. Being the oldest and the largest bank in India, how have you changed your product to cater to the new consumer requirement?
When we talk about the individual at the center, at the periphery, also at the top of everything that banks offer, more and more we try to put the ingredients on a self-service mode. Hmm. So what is happening is that the banks are today having a common set of services which could be mixed and matched by the customer himself. Hmm. And his lifestyle is seamlessly integrated into the bank's offerings. Hmm. And that is how we are positioning, that the customer is the king. C decides what is to be done, and C has all the ingredients to cook her own recipe. Hmm. That is the way we are positioned.
Okay, but you know, your problem is not similar to the likes of, let's say, an Axis or a Kotak Bank. Yeah. You already have a huge customer base.
Yeah.
How do you evolve based on that customer base's demand?
No, it is it's a great, you know, fun to be in the modern times where you have 425 million customers, and they range from the digital native, which is the millennials, mm. to the digitally transformed, like myself or like yourself, who is a good professional who has understood the value of digital. There are digital fence sitters who are dabbling their hands there, and of course there are digitally averse, mm. the wealthy older people who want everything to be done assisted mode.
Yeah.
So we will have to, have probably six variations of technology to cater to them.
Hmm.
So positioning is not a single solution. In today's world, probably banks which are catering to an entire spectrum, and especially hmm. State Bank of India, which is a proxy to the nation.
Hmm.
So we have probably six or eight variations of technology to individualize and offer it.
Hmm. Okay. For someone like a Kotak, we saw an 811 coming up last year, and also it was launched around the IPL, so it really caught on with the consumer. What was the need of the market to launch a platform like an 811?
So I think, as Mr. Mahapatra said, and I fully agree, India is changing, and it's really changing fast. It doesn't matter where you are today. Unlike in the past where we used to talk about metro, mail and millennials, the 3M formula, right?
Hmm.
I think that formula has changed. So people are ready to adopt, they're ready to change.
Hmm.
The loyalty is gone.
Hmm.
And I think in the past where the products like the banking products or any product used to be primary, I think the product has started moving to service,
hmm.
and experience has become the key. And bringing in insights like a lot of customers said, hey, I don't use bank as frequently. Why do I have to pay a lot of fee and charges?
Hmm.
So that also got baked in into creating a service and experience rather than saying a saving account is a product or a credit card is a product.
Hmm.
And I think what we are learning at the back of 811 experience, bringing all these insights, hmm. converting it into our experience and a value proposition, going out in the market without any prejudice to say this product is only for millennials or this is only good for metro, opening it up to the entire India or Bharat. And I think we realized that there is a large market out in places where we never even had a physical branch. All this long, it was our mindset to say branch is required to acquire a customer. Here are customers who are saying, I just want to connect with you digitally. So what if you don't have a branch? So I think these are some of the amazing learnings that led to not just launching 811, but keep learning on an ongoing basis and keep improving on that experience.
So you just brought in a great point where you said that, you know, a large market exists where there is not even a physical branch. Okay, here we are talking about bringing in technology, let's say to help a customer. It takes a lot of time to even build and develop such a kind of technology to cater well to the consumer. How beneficial is it for a consumer, a bank like, let's say, an Axis, and you know, how has it helped you connect better with your consumer, A, and how has it really helped you in your revenues?
If you look at channels, right, we first had branches, then we had phone banking, then we had the email channel. And currently with all these WhatsApps, and we're having a chat channel, and we recently launched a chatbot. And what really alarmed and what really surprised us was the set of questions that customers, we thought it's a new sort of a, you know, novelty sort of an item, will customers take to it? And the numbers really, you know, just surprised us, because the kind of questions that we expected from customers were really around banking, were really around what happened to my application form, what happened to my credit card, what happened to my loan, am I eligible for a loan? And that's not just it. They expected even transactions to happen. So they said, listen, I'm not here to just digest the five ways of ordering a checkbook. If you want me to order a checkbook, can I do it over a chatbot? And that's prompted us in terms of people are really short of time here. And therefore, each of your channels has to address it there and then. So today, our chatbot allows you to order checkbooks. You can even transfer funds, all in a conversational sort of a mode. But I think the point here is it's conversation banking on a one-on-one basis. And therefore, one-on-one for, let's assume you've got more than about 2 crore customers. Doing at that scale, you have to have digital. And that, so therefore, it helps us to achieve that market of one, address that market of one. So it helps us to obviously get more customers today. If you look at ASAP, which is our digital account, 30% of our new acquisitions is coming from ASAP. So obviously it has an impact in terms of revenue, because you're not addressing, you're not incurring a big cost to get these kind of customers, and you're able to address that market of one in a very individualized manner.
So what kind of insights do you get through these chatbots? As you said, there are some questions that you never expected a customer will ask you ever. But sometimes, let's say, even a page of like a net banking page of a bank can be really very complicated. So how does it help, you know, provide a better service to your consumer?
With the chatbot, what we realize is that we're living in a sort of boundaryless world. So when you say, listen, I've applied for a credit card, he expects, where is the credit card? Much like a food ordering app, he expects, is the boy out there delivering it, and where is the delivery, right? It's, you can't keep saying your order is getting processed and it will be delivered. You have to get specific. So that's one big learning that we had. And from a bank perspective, we've always been typically saying that it will take you know, 2-3 days. Customers today, I don't think have the patience to wait for these kind of long. So therefore, this micro management of these journeys was one of the things that we really learned.
You know, Radhika, I want to ask you, how has a product like PaisaBazaar.com become more relevant in today's time?
So we started our journey 4 years back, and many of the people who are sitting here are our partners. It's been an exciting time, because we started by saying, okay, there are some products which are available digitally. But now every partner of ours, whether from an SBI till, say, a fintech startup, has something for the digital customer, ensuring that the customer can acquire it in maybe, say, half an hour. We're talking in terms of minutes, in terms of acquisition. So we've sort of spread out our focus. And what we've seen is that we have inquiries for loans from 800 odd cities, like what Deepak was mentioning, that we had people who've come in from 800 different cities. I didn't know some of the city names, but we just got it from the IP address. And then we disbursed loans for customers out of 380 cities. So that's the kind of impact that we know that we are generating over being present. So it's not a product, it's a platform. It helps customers bring them banking to their doorstep, really, because you know, currently the first port of call now, if any customer wants something, is the internet, and they look at ways to compare features. So I think comparison, knowing what's right, what's their right, rather than just picking up their bag and walking to a bank, gone are those days. Currently, customer wants to know what are the options available.
Rakesh, life insurance, it has always been like a very touchy topic for a customer to take a leap. So how have you guys worked towards making take that leap a little bit more faster?
To me, the center piece over here is customer experience, right? And from an insurance company standpoint, we've always been accused of being laggards when it comes to technology and legacies. And the other bit is, you know, we are seen as very complex and opaque product, so to speak. So from our standpoint at Future Generali, I think we took the battle head on. We wanted to change the narrative. People believe that insurance is complex. It's too much of paperwork and back and forth and all that stuff, right? So the idea was, how can you create product which are very simple, easy to understand, almost like bite-sized products where customers can buy very easily and get the whole experience with insurance, which could be defining experience. So we came up with a cancer protect plan, which has been very well received by the market. You have to need no papers for that. You simply can go online, buy this product in about 10 to 12 minutes flat. You have a Aadhaar, which every 100 crore people today have Aadhaar. And you need to have a credit card or debit card or bank account. Even wallet will do, right? So today you can buy one product in just about 10 to 12 minutes flat. Now that's redefining the consumer experience to our mind.
So digital has really changed the way in which, you know, you guys have shaped your products. Before slipping into a break, Veer, I want to ask you the final question. You know, so these guys are sitting on a lot of data. Chatbots and AI and all the technology has become a norm. How can really Martech help these guys better serve their customers in the coming days?
So one of the most important things that digital has brought about for the financial sector is that the customer today is looking at financial products also like a, you know, supermarket. So you can think of, you know, the financial product companies, the BFSI sector as we call it in India, they are rethinking of themselves as, you know, consumer goods companies. You know, if you look at the examples that are being discussed, it's about, you know, as good as buying, you know, a TV online or a mobile phone online. People, you know, the expectations of customers are that, you know, I have to buy it on demand. So that's the expectation that I would have of any online app. I should be able to track my order. It should be very easy to do so. So these are things that you would normally associate with a, you know, app like a Flipkart. But if you see the discussion today, it's is also about financial products. So that's one of the big changes that, you know, most the digital is doing to financial products is like rethinking themselves as financial supermarkets. In such a scenario, all the MarTech that we are talking about, which is applicable for, you know, other digital products, is also applicable for the financial sector. And I think that's a big change that is happening.
All right. It is time for us to take a short break, but insights into the world of marketing and technology will continue on the other side of this break. Stay with us. Hello and welcome back to Martech Marathon 12x25. We are in discussion with the marketing leaders of the biggest Indian banks and financial institutions to understand how they are taking the digital approach for reaching out to the customers. Welcome back. We spoke about how you cater better to the consumers, but how has, you know, adopting the digital route really helped you gain a better revenue for your bank?
The digital route to marketing of products and services, because products and services some time back used to be, you know, the content used to be manufactured centrally and it is to be distributed for print media, electronic media, so on and so forth. Take, for example, YONO, our new digital product where we are, you know, putting everything together. It is a digital bank, it is a e-commerce player, it is also a, you know, financial superstore. So you will have to devise content on the go. What we do is that, you know, depending on the customer's past behavior, we give contextualized products and services. So marketing has gone from, you know, being centrally manufactured to completely technology-driven, many times AI and machine learning catered and contextualized, so that the customer feels that, you know, sees indeed the center of attraction.
And for example, your designation says that you are the chief digital officer. So how does it work hand in hand with your marketing team, and what is it that you keep in mind while developing a product for your customer?
Primarily, the way we look at marketing from the technology perspective is, what is it that technology can solve? So typically within digital, we break it into a customer acquisition, engagement, and cross-sell, or selling some products and services. Now, within each of these journey, things are changing, as I told you, because now finding out where the customer is, that itself has changed. Unlike in the past, where you used to have a largest feet on street or branches, identifying those customers, targeting those customers. So that's where a lot of stuff on the programmatic buying is coming, as to which medium to use to target what kind of customer at what value. And that makes you relook at the whole customer acquisition strategy. There is a large fraud ecosystem that also exists around all the digital marketing. So again, there are technology solutions which are there to make sure that when you are bringing in customers, you are bringing in right kind of customers at a right cost. So I think the way we look at this is, marketing brings what marketing understands better. Digital brings more from the how technology can supplement marketing or product. But at the end of it, what connects everybody is customer experience and customer journey.
Radhika, how, according to you, can aggregators probably use MarTech to deliver better to the customers?
So there are three, four things which make up a banking. The first is, of course, capital. So we are not competing there. We know the experts who have the capital, and they're going to do that. The other two parts is access to large pools of customer, which there are customers with the banks and financial institutions whom we partner. Plus, we also have like 20 million customers visiting us every month. So that's the customer pool. And the third most important part is data and the algorithms that you can build on that. So each of us, if we do our parts well, it's like the era of specialization coming back all over again. So how MarTech actually helps us is, we have 20 million customers coming every month, so the data machines are churning round the clock. So you have data, rich data of customers, which channels are they coming from, what do they read on the site, what are they searching for, what have they applied in the past, which browser are they using, are they app customer, how do they respond to campaigns, whole lot of data. But the good part is, we being a startup, we are constrained on capital. We don't go behind the next big technology saying, okay, let's put this and that's our panacea. We try to figure out one small thing at a time, just figure out, okay, one small improvement at a time. So it's like, if you are at 1.01 power 365, you are like 10 times better than what you were yesterday or the last year. So that's what we believe in, to take one small step, figure out each one part, and then sort of go back with the banks and collaborate to make it work for the customer.
Rakesh, this is something that we touched upon when we did a discussion on retail, where, you know, there's a thin line between connecting with the customer and invading that customer's privacy and, you know, chasing the customer all the time in different platforms. Is this something which I've seen happening on a lot of insurance platforms that are there? So how do you, draw that fine line and, you know your limit on when to tap the customer and stop?
So traditionally, marketing role has been to create context for the customer. And one of the assumptions earlier was the context remains static. Now, today with digital and mobile, the context changes on the fly, right? And it changes for different customers. So for example, if I'm going to office sitting in my car and I see an accident happening, there's a context which has gotten created, right? It could be me. Now, therefore, the role of marketer in MarTech, therefore, and the advantages MarTech can offer today is that you can really do a lot of context setting for the customer and be when the customer is ready in that context. And I think that's where we are wanting to be, given the power of data without invading the privacy. But giving the power of data, we want to be omnipresent. And the whole thing about MarTech is about giving the customer an omni experience, because I am ready when I am ready. You can't dictate when I am ready. You know what I mean? So if I am, 90% of the customer go online before they buy, even offline. And if I'm not there when I need you, then you're pretty much not in the scene. And once I've presented an interest, and if you're not really talking to me at that point in time, my context changes very fast. That's the challenge we are grappling with, and that's what essentially MarTech solutions really help you deliver to the customer. And therefore, once you do that, you understand the context of the customer. You don't have to invade. the customer's privacy, right? You're right there when the customer is ready and thinking about it.
Finally, Veer, I would like to ask you, you know, with banks, barring, let's say, Paisa Bazaar, with banks, how can Martech help create that seamless experience of that bank brand across online and offline?
So while we talked about how digital is making banks, you know, think of themselves and their offerings as consumer goods, but it is also true that financial products are considered purchase. They are not impulse buy. You know, mm-hmm. they don't purchase an insurance policy on impulse. So since they are considered purchase, there is a buyer's journey mm-hmm. before a purchase. What Martech helps you to is identify at what stage in the buying journey the customer is. And as Mr. Mohapatra said, it could start with a trigger, Rakesh was just saying, that you know you have seen something and that's a trigger to you and you are now thinking about insurance. That's a trigger stage in the buyer's journey. At trigger stage, you need to be dealt with differently than when you are at a consideration stage and when you are, you know, at a pre-purchase stage. So what Martech helps you do is in the buyer's journey, because it's a considered purchase, a financial product, helps you slot and identify user, where is he in that buyer's journey, and deal with that customer accordingly. That's the main part about Martech.
All right. Thank you so much, guys. Thanks for speaking to us. And with that, it's a wrap on the episode of Martech Marathon 12x25. We'll be back next time with another insightful discussion on the dynamic world of marketing and technology. Goodbye.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.